12. If a ruler hearken to lies, all his servants are wicked. So, Father God, we understand and you understand and I understand, Father God, you and I understand that the wicked rulers, Father God, that utter lies through these modern day slavery programs, the rulers, when they hearken to lies and they hearken to the lies of the false witnesses and the hate stalkers that spread lies about your children and the persecuted lambs of these modern day slavery programs, Father God, throughout this world, their servants are wicked, Father God. The ones that serve the wicked rulers underneath these modern day slavery programs are wicked because they also utter lies, Father God, and spread lies about your children and the persecuted lambs through these modern day slavery programs, and they spread lies about me, Father God. So, verse 13, the poor and the deceitful man meet together. The Lord lighteneth both their eyes. Lord, Father God, I thank you. Even though the poor and the deceitful man meet together, and that goes to all the poor, needy, persecuted lambs and your children all over the world, Father God, we meet together with the deceitful persecutors that come against us through these modern day slavery programs from time to time. And Lord, you are the one that lightened both the eyes of the deceitful man and the eyes of the poor, Father God, and I thank you for lightening the eyes of your children and lightening the eyes of me as your child and the persecuted lambs everywhere in the world, and that you are lightening the eyes of our persecutors and the deceitful persecutors that come against us with your truth, Father God, with your truth, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name, in your light of truth, in Jesus Christ's name, to let these evildoers know what they're doing against us is wrong, Father God, and they need to repent to you and ask for your forgiveness for the wicked things that they do against the innocents and your children and the persecuted lambs and myself through these modern-day slavery programs of all types everywhere in the world, in Jesus Christ's name. Verse 14, the king that faithfully judgeth the poor, his throne shall be established forever. Father, I pray that you help all your children out there that have leadership roles and the persecuted lambs out there that have leadership roles, Father God, that faithfully judgeth the poor, that their throne shall be established forever, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name. Verse 15, the rod of reproof give wisdom, but a child left to himself bringeth his mother to shame. Father, I pray that you will help your children everywhere in the world and the persecuted lambs everywhere in the world that do have children, that are raising children of age, Father God, to have the wisdom, Father God, to use the rod and reproof upon their children, Father God, and not to leave their children left to themselves, because when they leave their children left to themselves, their children will bring shame to them, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name. So I pray that you will help all the Christian parents everywhere and the persecuted lambs that are parents, Father God, everywhere in the world, to use the rod and reproof, Father God, to give wisdom to their children and not to leave their children unattended and to themselves, so they won't bring, their children won't bring shame to them, Father, in Jesus Christ's name. Verse 16, when the wicked are multiplied, transgression increaseth, but the righteous shall see their fall. Father, even though the wicked persecutors that persecute your children and the innocent lambs and the persecuted lambs and myself through these modern day slavery programs are multiplied and transgression increaseth against your righteous lambs, against your children and against me as your child through these modern day slavery programs everywhere in the world, we as your children, as righteous children, Father, I as your righteous child and the righteous lambs shall see the fall of the wicked and rise up against us, Father, that do evil things against us. We shall see their fall, the fall of the wicked, Father God. that transgressed against the righteous lambs through these modern day slavery programs in Jesus Christ's name. Verse 17, correct thy son, and he shall give thee rest. Yea, he shall give delight unto thy soul. Father, I pray that you help your children everywhere in the world and all the persecuted lambs that do have children, that are raising their children, Father God, sons and daughters, that they, Father God, will correct their children, Father God, so their children can give them rest, Father God, and so their children can give delight unto their souls, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name. Verse 18, where there is no vision, the people perish, but he that keepeth the law, happy is he. Great verse. Father God, I pray that you will help myself as your child and all your children everywhere in the world, and all the persecuted lambs to have a vision from you, that you will give us a vision from you, Father God, that we will not be walking around with no vision, Father God. So we won't be people that perish, Father God, but you will help us to keep the law of your word, Father. Because when we keep the law, happy are we, Father. We are happy when we keep your law of your word, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name. So thank you, Father God, for giving all your children and all the persecuted lambs and myself as your child vision, Father God, and what you want us to do in our lives, the vision for us that you have for us, the plans that you have for us, for showing us that vision that you have for our individual lives and the plans that you have for our individual lives, despite of things being deterred in our lives, Father God, being deferred, our dreams being deferred because of the persecutors and the evil things that they do against us with the witchcrafts and with the evil scams and schemes, Father God, that they do against us through these modern day slavery programs and the oppressions and stuff. In Jesus Christ's name, for showing us the vision that you have for each one of us, Father, and showing me the vision that you have for me and the plans that you have for me, so we won't perish, so I won't perish, and that I am the one that keepeth your law, and happy am I when I keep your law, Father, in Jesus Christ's name, as well as all your other children that keep your law of your word, Father, and keep the law, in Jesus Christ's name. Verse 19, a servant will not be corrected by words, for though he understand, he will not answer. Father, I thank you, Father God, that your children that are servants and all the persecuted lambs that are servants, we will not be corrected by words, but though we understand, we will not answer, Father God. Verse 20, seest thou a man that is hasty in his words? There is more hope of a fool than of him. So, Father, I pray that you help myself as your child and all your children everywhere in the world and the persecuted lambs not to be people that are hasty in our words. Help me, please, Father, not to be hasty in my words, Father God, because there is more hope for a fool than of a person that's hasty in their words, Father God, and that you will help myself and your children and the persecuted lambs, Father God, to be kind in our words and edifying in our words and wise in our words, Father God, that the law of kindness will rule our lips and our tongues, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name. Verse 21, he that delicately bringeth up his servant from a child shall have him become his son at the length. Verse 22, an angry man stirreth up strife, and a furious man abounded in transgression. Father, I pray that you help myself as your child and your children that struggle with anger, or any of your persecuted lambs that struggle with anger, not to be angry people that stirred up strife, that you would deliver us from the spirit of anger and rage, even though we get abused and provoked by the antagonizers every day and the persecutors that persecute us, that you will help us not to be angry people that stirred up strife, and that you will help us to stay away from angry people that stirred up strife, and that you'll protect us from angry people that stirred up strife, especially the persecutors that are angry toward us that love to stir up strife against us to get us to operate in strife. and from furious people, Father, that abounded in transgression, because the persecutors are furious toward us, and they abounded in transgression and doing transgression against your children and the persecuting lambs and against me through these modern day slavery programs, Father God. That you will help us not to be around angry, furious people in Jesus Christ's name. And that's full of strife in Jesus Christ's name. Verse 23. Sorry for the pause. Verse 23. A man's pride shall bring him low, but honor shall uphold the humble in spirit. Very important verse. I see why the devil was trying to hold back my tongue on this one. So, Father God, I pray that you help myself and all your children everywhere in the world and the persecuted lambs, Father God, not to be given over to pride, Father God, so it won't bring us low. But we will be given over to honor, Father God, because when we have honor, it shall uphold the humble in spirit, Father God, that you will help your children and the persecuted lambs, Father God, to be humble. In spirit, to walk in humility, Father God, and not in pride, Father God, so we won't be brought low, Father God, but Father, we will be brought in honor when we walk in humility and when we uphold, Father God, the humble in spirit, Father God, in Jesus Christ's name. Verse 24, whoso is partnered with a thief hateth his own soul. He heareth cursing and read it not. So Father, I pray that you will help your children and the persecuted lambs, Father God, not to never partner with thieves, because when we partner with thieves, you said that we hate our own souls. But Father, we don't desire to hang around thieves, Father God, not knowingly anyway, Father God. We don't desire that. So I thank you for helping us not to hang around and partner with thieves, so we won't end up hating our own souls, and that we won't hear cursing and berate it not, because it's a curse behind theft. And it's a curse behind the persecutors that steal and rob from your children and the persecuted lambs and rob me through these modern day slavery programs that break in our apartments and homes and steal stuff from us, that steal our monies from us, our cars, and tear up things and steal things from us and our cars and homes, and steal our children from us, our pets, and steal other things, and our sleep and our time and our health, and through witchcraft or whatever, Father God, in all types of devious ways. Manipulative ways. So, Father God, these evil persecutors that steal from your people and the persecuted lambs and myself through these modern day slavery programs are cursing themselves, Father God, and bringing curses upon themselves when they steal and rob from your children and from the persecuted lambs and from myself as your child through these modern day slavery programs of all types everywhere in the world. In Jesus Christ's name. Verse 25, the fear of man bringeth a snare, but whoso putteth his trust in the Lord shall be safe. Father God, I pray that you will help myself and your children and the persecuted lambs everywhere in the world not to be people that fear man, Father God, so we won't bring a snare to us, Father, that we won't operate in the spirit of fear, Father God, nor the fear of man, that you will deliver any of your children and the persecuted lambs that struggle with any type of spirit of fear, including myself, from the spirit of fear and the fear of man, that we will fear you and not man. And that we will put our trust in you, Lord, so we can be safe, Father God. And I thank you that I, myself as your child, and all your children everywhere in the world, and all the persecuted lambs, put our trust in you, Father, in you, Jehovah Yah, in you, Lord, Jehovah Yah. And we are safe when we do that, Father, when we put our trust in you, Father, in Jesus Christ's name. Verse 26, many seek the ruler's favor, but every man's judgment cometh from the Lord. So, Father God, I thank you, Father God, for helping your children not to seek the favor of man, Father God, because you're the one that give us favor with man, and you give us favor from you, and favor cometh from you, Father God, And Father God, you are the one that judge these every man's judge.